Instagram.com.
Thanks for joining us for our second video on the coronavirus. If this is the first video you're seeing on that, please go back to our first video to get the introduction about what exactly is this coronavirus of 2019. They're calling it, as it turns out, it was discovered on the last day of 2019, December 31st. So what are the symptoms and what's going on with this virus clinically? So there was a great article that was published in The Lancet just recently about this. About 41 patients that came in to the hospital there and were diagnosed with molecular technique to show that they actually had the virus for the coronavirus. In those patients, about 41, 98% of them had fever, 76% had cough, and 55 had shortness of breath. What was lacking here was the sneezing, runny nose, that type of thing that you would expect to see with a regular virus. Those are kind of lacking here. What did they find? This is a pretty good indication of if you're sick enough to go to the hospital, this is what you might expect. So just so you're aware, 100% of these were confirmed with molecular technique of being the 2019 nCoV, which is the coronavirus. So what was the median age? Median age was 49. So these are not old people. 73% of them were men. And surprisingly, only 32% had underlying comorbidities. Now, what's interesting is that 66% of these people that were hospitalized were exposed to that specific meat market. And as I mentioned, there was one family grouping that seemed to have gone to this meat market that came down with this virus. What's concerning is that it took about 8 days to develop the shortness of breath in those patients who did develop shortness of breath after the illness. So in other words, there was an incubation period of maybe about a week or two, and then there was the illness that lasted for 8 days, and then there was the shortness of breath. And what did that shortness of breath lead to? In 100% of the cases, there were signs of pneumonia on chest CT, and 29% of these patients developed ARDS, which is a pretty serious and significant lung disease, leading to the last statistic here was that the mortality was 15%. So there's about 6 patients that died as a result of this. And one of them was a young man that had no comorbidities at all. And so that's actually rather concerning. So what about treatment? Well, as it turns out, treatment is just supportive, which means if they're dry, you give them fluids, which means if they can't breathe, you put them on a ventilator. But there is no medication that is going to speed up the effect of the virus to get it out of your system more quickly. So in terms of actual specific treatment, there is no treatment. There is no medication. But there is a drug company called Regeneron, which is looking into a treatment and has some promising developments. And there is no vaccine. However, the United States NIH is saying that they're actually developing one shortly. So what is actually being done about it? Well, as of this recording, there's about 35 million people in China that are on lockdown. And it's all around this area called Wuhan. So what should you do? Well, I would avoid going to Wuhan at this point. Number two, if you have traveled to Wuhan and you get sick, make sure you call a medical professional immediately and make sure you tell them that you are sick and that you're from Wuhan in that area, and make sure that you take appropriate precautionary measures of isolation before you go in. Listen to what their advice is in terms of how to present yourself so that you don't spread this virus to somebody else. This is a developing story, and we'll be giving updates as they come in. But at this point, it seems as though the worst is not over yet, and the amount of people that are infected continue to rise to well over 1,300. Stay tuned for more. Thanks for watching this video.